Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to XCOM 2 and our Commander playthrough. We're ready to go on our next retaliation strike because Advent has struck again. This time we're going on Operation Failing Shroud and we're gonna take Vinny with his EMP rounds. Christoph and Jazz are Rangers, Ulrich and Yang are Grenadiers, and Benito is back in the saddle as our combat specialist. So let's launch this mission. So again, we really need to succeed here, save at least 6 civilians, otherwise that area will not be pleased with us.
Sky Ranger deployed.
Sky Ranger deployed, ready to go. And here we go.
Remote reconnaissance picked up heavy comms traffic from alien forces moving to attack a resistance outpost in this region. And we're the only ones with any chance of stopping them. We're heading in to lock down the area. Neutralize all hostile contacts with extreme prejudice.
I think it's the first time it's not in the new Arctic where we started. So Eastern Europe is under attack, the resistance haven Rebel Hills. So as always with retaliation strikes, neutralize all enemy forces and rescue at least 6 civilians. The Shadow Chamber notifies us that there are 11 enemies in here and one unknown enemy type, so I'm really curious about what that is going to be. Of course, I have an idea what that's going to be, but I'm not going to spoil that just yet. So, two Rangers. They're going to come in really handy, if I'm not mistaken.
Attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians.
Nobody starts in concealment,
so did we.
Except for Christoph, of course.
For deployment on this
so we're gonna use him to go and rescue some civilians as a start. Seems like we have two civilians pretty close by. Of course, one of them can be a faceless. Are there any more civilians around here? This is a pretty big map. As always, because retaliation strikes always take place on really big maps, but I only see two civilians. So, Christoph, I'm going to take a chance with you, and I think we're going to just pull through and head for that. Ooh.
These chrysalids seem a little smaller than I remember. Then again, it was never really their size we had to worry about.
Wow, okay, that's really fast for chrysalids, but I think we're gonna have to deal with that as fast as we can. So I'm gonna antagonize them with a sniper shot on, well, 85 it seems. And they're gonna come closer, allowing us to finish them off. Because chrysalids, that's the new enemy type I expected them to be here. But they're extremely fast melee enemies. So I'm gonna shoot at one, just pulling their focus. And let's deal with them one at a time. So there we go, 5 damage done. Get over here. Because they also usually get an attack when they spot somebody. But since Christoph is the only one close enough to get hit, I don't think they will attack him. He's, of course, stuck now. But I think with a single grenade, we can easily take care of that. So let's just get Ulrich a bit closer.
Positive.
And use one of his grenades to just blast away all the armor and kill that one chrysalid that's close by. So something like this should be fine. Yeah, thank you, Ulrich. Just do that and kill that one chrysalid. And hopefully doing a lot of damage to the other ones. There we go. So all the armor is shredded and there's two more left. But we have the troops to deal with that. So no problem there. It's good that we've seen them so early on. That's mostly Christoph's his benefit, of course, that we can use him as a sort of scout. Yang, just get a bit closer. Benito. Yeah, just out in the open. They're melee fighters, so cover won't do anything anyway. But ooh, look at Jazz's reach. That is amazing. If I lose Christoph as a scout, I can reconceal Jazz to use him as our next scout if Christoph is out of concealment. But before that, we're just going to use... You know what? I'm actually going to first try and kill those chrysalids from over here. So 86 should kill. Please do. There we go. Would have been nice if he could hit, she could hit the chrysalid behind him as well, because they were in a single file. But that's one chrysalid down, and then Benito on 83 shot with his plasma rifle. And that was a miss, but of course he marked it. Which should allow Jazz to kill him easily. So Jazz, go next to Ulrich and then blast away at the chrysalid. So 97 because of the marking. And there we go, goodbye. Thank you very much. So I wanted to use that last turn to save that one civilian. Hair trigger, free action, ooh. Okay. That doesn't happen all that often. Oh, there's another civilian inside of the building over there, so that's interesting. So do I want to rescue that one already? I think it's a bit too risky. Although, of course, a civilian saved is something that I don't really have to. So 11 enemies. We killed 3 just now, so that means there's still 8 on the map. How big is the chance that we're gonna see something if we go over there? Probably pretty big. So I'm just gonna put him on Overwatch. And maybe even use Christophe to get closer to the civilian. There we go.
Orders confirmed, moving out.
And that's our last action. There's something moving on the right, so I think I made the right decision not moving on that civilian immediately. We're gonna see on our next turn. There's a lot of movement. So I'm actually thinking that there might be another squad of chrysalids. And that's the heavy mech. Killing our first civilian. I'm sorry, Riku, that we couldn't get there in time, but that was far, far away. Okay. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Okay, so that's what I mean with the chrysalids being extremely fast. And that was a graze. So look how fast these things are. And they spotted Christophe as well. Oh god, what the fuck is going on? Jesus Christ, ow! That is ridiculous, come on! Aren't there 3 chrysalids? There usually are 3 chrysalids, but look at this! Oh, we didn't bring Hugh, that might have been my mistake. So we can't heal the chrysalid poison either. Christophe, go over here and save that civilian. That's something at least we can do. There we go. And then we're in a bit of a pickle. I'm gonna start positioning everybody a bit further because we need to move, of course. Yang, go over here in the corner. You can still move, so that's good. And then start by shredding this one chrysalid over here. She might kill him, but that means she's gonna have to do full damage. And another thing to note about chrysalids is that they are completely immune to critical hits, so you can't do extreme damage to them with one shot, sadly. So this one is pretty damaged, so I might actually be able to kill him with one shot. So let's try that. Yeah, Benito duck, thank you very much. And she actually missed an 84% shot. That's ridiculous. Still moving indeed. So why didn't you just kill the thing? Ulrich, I want to be careful though. I'm gonna put him in this little corner over here. Vinny, I could use his face-off ability if we get the chance, but I'm first gonna try our other shots. Because we really need to kill these things. 92 or 90? Wait, what? Oh, 92 is the back one for some reason. So I can do a lot of damage with this. So let's try it out. Yeah, that's a kill. There we go. And then Jazz is pretty close to just fire away with his shotgun. So I think I'm going to use his shotgun to just take revenge on the damage he has received. Although I can't actually kill him. Slash won't kill him either, so... You know what? I'm just gonna see what I can do with Christophe's shot from over here. Just try that. There we go, 9 damage. And then I'm just gonna use the slash to finish him off. Very hard target indeed. So, and now Jazz, just use your sword and take care of this guy. There we go. Taken care of. So that's 5 enemies already. Can I put he ran away, so I might assume that he's not a faceless. He's in a pretty good position over there, so I might just pull Vinny closer so that we have another Overwatch shot. Do I need to put Ulrich higher? He could get here as well, which might not actually be such a bad idea at this point. Just the more civilians I can save now, the better, in my opinion. Because that's another civilian that can't be shot at. And since he ran away already, that kind of proves... I think that proves that he's not a faceless. Not really sure. I might be wrong about that and proven wrong in a minute. But let's put him on Overwatch. Ooh, the chrysalid poison is apparently pretty heavy. I hope that wears off. Because otherwise we're going to have to get him out of here. Oh, they missed. That is really good. They don't often miss on civilians, so that's really, really good. What the hell is that? Are there more chrysalids? Oh, no. They get another shot because they missed on the civilian. That's stupid. Shivani Javad, I'm sorry for that. Do have to be careful with Jazz's poison, because if that keeps going... We're gonna have to be careful. We still have, you know what? We still have restoration here as well. So I'm just gonna put Benito in full cover over there just to scout things out a bit. And then I'm gonna use his restoration ability because I think I can do that, right? So I can heal everybody that needs to be healed. There we go. Oh, I'm really glad I got that for him. Is that just... Does that heal the poison as well? 5 HP healed, but don't know if that just removed the poison, because I didn't get... Can I check that out? It doesn't look like he's poisoned anymore, but I don't even know if that is here already. I think I'm going to use Jazz and reconceal with him. And then try and get a bit closer to the rest of the field here, because I can only see one civilian for now. The one over there. Oh no, there's one over there as well. Okay, there we go. Another thing about chrysalids is that they can burrow underground. So that's why they, you saw them spawning in erratic places. It's kind of bugged out a bit. And they can actually use that ability to get really close, really fast. But Benito's scanning ability actually blocks that as well because he can reveal them immediately. I got you. You're safe. Okay, so that's another one. So that's really good. We have three really, really quickly without any problems. Ulrich, do I want to put you closer? I think I'm going to wait. I don't want to wait. I'm just going to go for it. It seems like there's no enemies over there as well. So Yang, go a bit further as well. Vinny. If there aren't any enemies over there, would there be if I just put him over here in the corner? I'm gonna have to risk it, I think, because he's starting to lag behind a bit, so... No, okay, so we're pretty good. I'm gonna use, now that he's in concealment, I'm gonna use Jazz to get one tile further. That might actually trigger something. No, okay. Get Yang over here then. And just keep Ulrich on Overwatch. Because he's the only one that still has an action left to just start shooting at stuff. We know... Yeah, okay, there we go. That's good, that's good. Because we get their attention then instead of on the civilians. Okay, so that's one. And the only one, of course, because we only have one Overwatch shot. And that's a hit! Thank you, Ulrich! That's 6 damage we don't need to do anymore. So we killed 5 enemies. There were 11 on the board, so we're still looking at 6 enemies. So why are there only 2? Oh, that's probably because of the faces that count as well. Although they weren't counted by the Shadow Chamber, if I'm not mistaken. I could just sword this guy. The officer right here, but I do want to take care of that... That shield bearer over there as well. I'm gonna try and get a bit closer. I know it's dangerous because that mech is over here somewhere as well. You know what? We have the perfect candidate to do that. Jazz, get in a sort of flanking position over here. Seems like he's doing okay over there. He doesn't even spot anything else, so... am I gonna risk it and put him over here? To save that guy. I actually might. I can't put him on the same position as the civilian is on, but I can... yeah, I'm just gonna do that. And now that's gonna be a faceless. Yeah, fuck! Okay. I'm not sure if he gets an attack in already, because if he can, he's gonna just... revealed, yes indeed. So now we have an extra enemy. Great. You have to be careful with acid bombs and the like as well, because they might actually do damage to the civilians if they wander into those areas. Vinny, you have a few shots if you want to, so let's put you over there. There we go. Then we have Benito. I can put you a bit further as well if I want to. That would be a good position. Can I get upstairs here somehow? I could easily use Christophe to get a running gun shot in. Go over here and just blast the shield barrier away, which I think is the better option. As long as I'm sure that I can take care of the faceless over there. I can get a nice shot from over here. 95, which is really good. And then Yang... I think Yang is going to have to shoot at the faceless as well, except if I use her for a grenade. So let's put Yang over there.
Absolutely.
Benito. What are your shots at the... ooh. Only at the shield bear. That's interesting. So do I actually have shots on the officer? Oh, I do. Over there. 52. Might actually try 52s at... with the... with my pistol, because that can actually do 6 damage with a normal shot. That was a miss. I have a few shots left.
Next time.
I might actually try that, because I think I can actually use face-off after first pistol shot as well, because this is my second shot, but that's the first action. 5 damage. 5 damage, okay. Next up, I'm gonna try the 95 at the faceless, because he's in a really, really good position to do that. That sounds like a hit, 6 damage. So that's still 4 damage left, probably. Yeah, okay. No biggie. Now, Vinny, it's time to show off your new... Wait, what? That was not... I used lightning reflexes, right? And then a normal pistol shot. Oh, I moved already. That's my mistake. Not that big of a problem. I'm just gonna have to be sure here. So I'm gonna use Benito to kill the faceless. There we go. Goodbye. And then Yang's grenades should just reach over to the shield bear, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we can. So I'm just gonna do this. And take out the armor. And of course the officer's gonna be dead as well. Boom indeed. There we go. Armor shredded and acid burn on the shield bear, but that didn't destroy the tree for some reason. So I'm gonna have to risk Christophe getting a more dangerous position. Probably around here next to the tree with the running gun. So let's run and gun. Get through the entire map over here.
Good to go.
And now we're gonna have to... ooh, hopefully I'm not gonna get spotted, because... okay. Seems fine. Seems fine. 85. That's actually not that good, but 85. Here we go. Please hit. Oh, thank you very much. Whew. How much damage was that? Because that didn't really show. And that was my last action. I can actually use Implacable to save the civilian over here, which I think I'm going to do. And now I'm gonna spot something probably. Yeah, okay. 4 civilians saved. That is really good. And there's... oh, shit. What? Okay. Oh, there he is. What the fuck? What? Isn't that... because I always found it strange that there were only two chrysalids in that second batch. So that's probably the last chrysalid of that batch. Why is nobody seeing that thing? It's right over there. That is annoying. Which means I'm gonna have to be really careful. And it seems like the healing, the restoration ability did clear Jazz's poison. Which is really good. Because if I look, if I put him over here, he's gonna be able to see inside of the church. And I think the mech is inside of the church as well. So the better thing to do here is, I think, just put up an overwatch position. So get everybody a bit closer. Maybe even put... No, okay, I thought he could go up there. Let's put Vinny a bit closer as well.
Seems doable.
Benito, move him up. I'm just gonna move everybody up slowly, but only one action. So that I can use overwatch shots if I need to.
I can handle that.
That's good. So I think that gave us a bit of insight in the inside of the church. Yeah, just this corner. So they're gonna be in the back of the church probably. And then Ulrich over here next to Benito. Yang, move her up to maybe, yeah, inside of the building now that there's an opening over there. And then just put, I think I've been through everybody now. Let's put everybody on overwatch and let that chrysalid come to us, because I don't want to get hit again by that thing. Oh, come on. Yeah, get over here. Are you going to teleport? Oh, that mech is far away. Oh, they're at the edge of the map. Jesus Christ, I'm going to have to book it over there, because we're at 7 enemies right now, so that's the last batch of enemies. Because if I kill that chrysalid, we have 3 more enemies left. Yeah, thank you. In my crosshairs. Bam! 7 damage, and then probably one more hit. We'll kill it off. Look at it. It's blocking the shots. And goodbye. So that's 8. So that means the group with the mech is probably the last one. So we're gonna have to move up carefully. And with carefully, I mean I'm just gonna run inside of the church.
Aucun problème.
So I think they just moved into view. Yeah, there we go. We haven't lost any more civilians. Because there's like 4 civilians surrounding them. Oh, goddammit, the mech is out of sight. The only problem I have now is that Christoph is at the entire opposite of the map right now. So I probably won't be able to use him. But we still have plenty of other options. So I put Jazz the furthest over there. Ooh, this is going to be annoying. If I can, I'm going to try and just destroy the entire building. So that I can create a sort of sideline for the rest of the troops that are just lagging behind a bit. So, but first, we still have the Mimic Beacon as well. So if all else fails, I know what I can do. So I'm going to put Jazz over there. Because there's, I think it's an... Actually, didn't get a good view. So a shield bear, that looks like a heavy shield bear. A normal trooper, well, an advanced trooper. And I think the mech is hiding behind this tombstone over here. So that's annoying that I don't see him yet. Because otherwise I could have tried to hack it already. So, Yang. Am I gonna waste one of your grenades to just blow us a path? You know what, just go over there and see what you can see. Nothing. That mech has to be... What? I saw it going over there, but for some reason, it's invisible. I can't really fire at anything. And I can't, of course, because I don't see the mech, I can't even... Jesus Christ, this is annoying. I think I'm gonna guess it. Because I think he's over here. So if I hit him, yeah, because there's one tile over there that's grayed out, and I think that's where the mech is, but for some reason, I can't spot him over there. So just use an acid bomb right on top of there. Just a wild guess, not that wild of a guess, it's an educated guess, but I think he's over there. Yeah, there he is. So the heavy mech is burning from acid, and the elite trooper as well. And I think that took care of most of the armor of the mech, but it... I don't think it destroyed... Yeah, it didn't destroy the pillar, so I can't see him yet. Jesus Christ, how... Is that angle so weird that he just can't see that? Then let's move Gustav up further, because we can't really do anything else with him. We still have another grenade left, if we want to. And that is a normal grenade, so I'm actually going to use Ulrich to drop another grenade over there. So, normal grenade, please. And then, at the same position, can I hit them both again? Ooh, I can. Look at that, just blast the area. Thank you, Ulrich. Just take care of everything over there. We'll probably kill the trooper as well. There we go. And there's the mech, I think. Hello? So now, how do I position Vinny so that he can see the mech? Can I put him over here? Is that gonna be close enough? Yeah, let's go over there. I don't think he's gonna get acid burned over there. Oh, and he's just outside of my reach. That's too bad, but. Now that he's damaged that far, I think I'm gonna use Benito to try a combat hack. If that fails, I still have the Mimic Beacon, so... But if you have that heavy mech, that's gonna come in really, really handy. So, Haywire Protocol. Yes, whatever you said in Italian, I don't understand that. Sadly. Italian is a really cool language, actually. Really sexy. Temporarily disable the unit or take control. Well, I think we're gonna try and take control, right? We're just... Yeah, let's try that. Oh, yes. Oh, look at that. Almost 90% of the hack completed. Control enemy successful. So that's good. Hacked, but I'm still going to use the Mimic Beacon just to be certain that the shield bearer doesn't attack me. Because I don't think I can use the mech immediately now. I can only use him in the next turn. So... I'm gonna move Vinny even closer as well, just so we can use him better in the next turn. Yeah, and that's it. So, Mimic Beacon. Let's put him over there. There we go. Shielding us from the shield bearer. How ironic. Is he just gonna fire at the Mimic Beacon? Yeah, and he's gonna take damage, of course, which is good. Because we're gonna need to get rid of him either way. But we could set him on a suicide mission in a minute. So he's gonna flank the Mimic Beacon, which is good because he leaves his full cover. That's actually not that much damage for a flanking shot. And now we can easily try and take him out. Just see who I'm gonna use to just do that. I'm actually gonna try and use the mech first. So just gonna put him right next to the... Because I think I can actually damage him ourselves. Since we're acid burning, I think we can just use the micro missiles to... Are we behind that wall? I don't think we're behind that wall, right? Yeah. Nope, nobody's behind the wall. Just want to make sure. And destroy everything here. And that's actually a triple purpose. So it's going to destroy his armor, remove his cover, and damage the mech as well, which is really, really good. So micro missiles. Yes, I want to do friendly damage this time for this one time. There we go, armor shredded, and 5 damage to the shield bearer, which is really interesting. And then, of course, we have plenty of opportunity to just murder everybody there. It kind of looked like Benito and Vinny were at the same position there, but... Jazz, I think you're due a promotion, right? So let's put you over there. I can do 98 on the shield bearer. He has 2 armor left, so I think I want to be certain here. So let's use... What kind of grenades do we still have left? We have a normal grenade from Yang, so let's use that and take care of the mech. Just gonna put her in a better position to do that. From over here behind the tree.
Absolutely.
And then use a grenade. And take care of the last armor of the shield bearer and, of course, of the mech as well. Yes, friendly damage again. I don't care. Boom! Baby. There we go. Mech deleted. And then Jazz, just finish it off for me, will you? Jazz, where are you, Jazz? There you are. Just shoot him in the face. Goodbye. Blammo, 10 damage. And now it's just a matter of deciding whether there's another faceless. Yeah, there we go. Didn't think that would happen. Hello, sir. You want a cookie or something? There we go. Goodbye. Woo! I think there was 10 civilians saved.
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
13 enemies. So yeah, the faceless do not count. Which is really, really interesting. So saved 10 out of 13 civilians in 8 turns. That was actually really, really good. One of our soldiers got wounded because of... Oh yeah, the chrysalid that got a hit in, right. At the very beginning of the mission. But, failing shroud, excellent rating. Thank you very much. I think we've never done so well on a retaliation mission. 10 civilians saved, that's actually really, really good. So, Jazz dealt most damage, but was under fire most. Yang made most attacks, and Christoph, as always, moved the furthest. Even though Jazz has the movement PCS chip, he still doesn't move as fast as Christoph does because of the run and gun. So, here we go. So that proves again how it really pays off to be really aggressive in retaliation missions like that. Jazz is limping a bit, 14 days because of that stabbing that the chrysalid did. But Christoph got a promotion. I would expect that more of them got a promotion, but apparently not. So Christoph, hidden ability on uncovered, that is really good. Covering fire, overwatch shots can now be triggered by an enemy action, not just movement, which is really good. And then a look at this. Now we have the choice between rapid fire, fire twice in a row at an enemy. Each shot suffers an aim penalty of minus 15. There is no cooldown on this ability. Or Reaper, a devastating chain melee attack where the first melee attack cannot miss. Each melee attack in Reaper mode grants an extra action, but further melee attacks have reduced damage. Which can possibly kill off a lot of low damage enemies, especially if you combine that with the pistol face-off, the pistol damage, the pistol shot ability from Vinny, where he can shoot at every enemy with his pistol, lowering their health. As where to a point that Jazz in that scenario, because I'm not going to use Christoph to get that ability, Jazz could kill each one of them off, which is really, really cool. But rapid fire is of course the one we're going to take with Christoph, so he can fire twice in a row using only a single action, by the way. But each shot suffers an aim penalty of minus 50, another ability that came from the previous game, actually. So rapid fire, and that brings Christoph to max level as well, so Colonel. So 18 health, 1 armor, 12 mobility, 80 aim, 20 hack, and 100 will. So thank you, Christoph, with 34 kills, by the way. And then Jazz is gravely wounded, so he's shaking his head in agony. So I'm going to put him in the infirmary really quickly. 6 chrysalid corpses, 2 faceless corpses, advent officer, 2 shield bearers, and a trooper. So not that bad, actually, because there was only one... Where's the wreck of the mech? Was that destroyed completely? Or was that because it was friendly that we didn't get that? That's weird. And then chrysalid autopsy. They may have features resembling a variety of terrestrials, insect species, but these creatures are deadlier than anything bred of our world. Their armored exoskeleton is of particular interest and may provide insights towards the creation of an armor suit capable of actively damaging enemy forces as they engage in combat. So hinting at an armor that would deal damage when we receive damage.
Today, Commander. Impressive work.
Monthly supply rewards increased across Europe. Income increased by 15 supplies. Thank you very much. So that is done. Another retaliation mission completed successfully. Babbling all over the place again. And with that done, I'm going to just head to the bridge because we're almost done with shielding the power coil. Ooh. Increase region income, that is very interesting. But we still had a supply drop that we need to finish scanning, like... Avengers, it's like a really, really tiny bit. Like... Probably half an hour that we need to scan that thing. There we go, ignore that. And get ourselves a bit more supplies, thank you very much. Now we're at 421. I think I'm gonna go with the cave, because I don't think the increased region income is that significant, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm just gonna start scanning, or continue scanning, because I think we started that once.
if I'm not mistaken.
So it's gonna have started, yeah, because we don't really need to start it, so... Oh, and there we go, the power coil. And we got 33 Illyrium crystals from that. Let's view the room. And I want to put in a power relay over here, and because it's over a shielded power coil, we get a significant increase to power output. So there we go.
Power relay construction initiated.
I'm not gonna use the engineers that we have. Oh, yeah, it's just construction. No. I thought I was gonna go inside of the room over there, so I want to go inside of the construction over there and
Commander,
do.
I appreciate you recruiting new staff for the engineering.
Yeah,
team.
Yeah, I know, Shen. There we go.
Still waiting for an assignment.
There we go. So there we go.
We can have them working on construction, excavation.
I know, Shen. I know. Shut up. And if that is completed, we're gonna get 10 power immediately. Can we actually see whether this is on top of a power coil or not? Because I think I upgraded this one already, but I didn't upgrade this one. But I'm wondering if this is on top of a power core. Because we don't really need that much power anymore, because we only have a few rooms we still have to make. I'm going to put one of the engineers in the Advanced Warfare Center over here. Just so Jazz over there heals a bit faster. And Benito is, I think Benito is always the one that comes and checks in on the other guys. I'm going to start clearing the rest of the alien debris down here. So I continued scanning the cave, and we now have a completed research in the beam cannon. Daigen has been less than eager to push the limits of the plasma weapons we've come up with so far, and while I agree that we have to be careful working within the confines of the ship, I still don't think we can let that hamper our progress. The aliens are going to send whatever they can after us, and we should be prepared. With that in mind, I've come up with a few improvements to the core plasma rifle design that should allow us to step up the power without substantial increases to weight. With the added intensity, it might also be possible to divide the targeting field into a multi-shot projectile stream. I'm guessing the heavier variant will be best suited to the Grenadiers. They don't seem all that concerned about carrying around unstable ordnance. Thank you, Shen. Beam cannon. Devising a more powerful high-volume beam weapon for our Grenadiers required substantial effort, but the firepower it brings is unquestioned. So the only weapon we still have left to check out is the plasma lance, but I think... is there something I want to check out first? I think I'm going to go with the Archon, because the melee weapon we can get from that is actually really interesting for Jazz, I believe. So
the
Archon autopsy.
Extensive fusion of both alien biological material and advanced mechanical support systems. The Archon is an unusually ornate design by alien standards. With an air of authority spurred by its distinctive appearance, I can only assume the aliens intended it to be something of a herald to the other forces.
And that's actually further boosted by the abilities. We haven't seen a lot of abilities from the Archon yet, but we know it can fly, so it's towering over the other enemies, but it also has a few boosting abilities that boosts the attacks from the other aliens as well. So
coordinates we discovered encoded on the genetic sample recovered from the Advent Black Site imply we may have only scratched the surface of the aliens' infrastructure as it relates to this Avatar project. We were fortunate to recover the genetic sample when we did. Otherwise, our path may have very well ended here.
I actually forgot that, but I do want to make one of those fancy armor suits in the Proving Grounds. So, there's a few very interesting ones here, of course, but I think the first one I want to make is just make the war suit, so we can have that energy shield if we want to. So let's put that in, and
I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander.
Since we have the resources right now, we have a bit of extra resources, I think I'm just gonna go for the raid suit as well. So there we go. And that just depletes our Illyrium core. So I think that's pretty well spent over there. So let's head back to the bridge. And in 5 days we should have a war suit, which are really, really awesome. But let's continue scanning. There we go. The many large caves found in this region long contributed to rumors that the original XCOM headquarters was once found here. While exploring the area, we did find the weathered remains of both human and alien aircraft abandoned since the invasion. After a few hours underground, our team successfully returned with a number of alien materials found hidden in the caves. So 36 alloys and 41 iridium crystals will come in handy really, really soon. Next up, I think I want to put a radio relay on New India, just because that's going to enable us to make contact quicker. Well, not quicker, but with less intel cost. Not that we're looking for more intel, but here we go. New India. Let's install a radio relay over here with 75 supplies.
Setting course for India.
And there we go. We couldn't even start building it properly before we got another guerrilla operation. So new target acquired. Let's review those. Very difficult on Western Europe. Resistance informant reduces the retaliation counter by 2 weeks. Not that big of a problem in my eyes. We are handled to deal with that. This is more interesting because we get another engineer, which I do want to have. It's probably the last one I'm going to take. Or that ranger. I think I'm going to go just for this one because the Viper rounds, I don't want to get hit by those in the near future. Yeah, difficult mission, protect the device. And it's an engineer, so I don't think that's that big of a problem. So let's go for West Africa this time. Operation Demon Mask.
Setting course for Sector 11, West Africa.
West Africa indeed. So let's head over there. I'm gonna check out what items I can build. Not that we have that many supplies left, so I don't think we'll be able to create another beam cannon. But let's just quickly go to over there. Yes, as I told, 250 supplies for the beam cannon. Is there anything else we should make? I don't think we should. No, we're pretty much good on all the other fronts. So yeah, let's head into this mission with... I do feel I want to keep him in there. Just because he's so handy and I'm just going to edit him so we can give him the mimic beacon. It's kind of a waste of a slot since we want to level everybody up a bit. But we're starting to get a really, really good team all around. So that's just an advantage we have right now. The first world problems, they call that. So let's give Emma the incendiary bomb as well. I still love her design. She looks so cool. I'm gonna just add her to the character pool after this. And everything else, I think I'm gonna put... Yeah, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna give Yang the... Oh no, they're not ready yet. The war suits. I'm just gonna have to wait with that then, because that would look really, really cool. But this is the squad we're gonna head into Operation Demon Mask with. But before that, I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it. As always, right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel. Because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. Also, don't forget you can still add characters to the character pool. Because the chances are pretty big that I'm going to start another season after this one completes. Not that we're that close to the ending already. But just something to keep in mind. So if you're not in the character pool right now, you'll be already in the next set if you want to. So keep that in mind. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.